But what about, we're talking about the physical, medical purposes of masks, you know, whatever that take is on that. But what about the psychological mm-hmm. effects of it? Mm-hmm. Because maybe it's just us. We have people that are just, they're totally comfortable wearing them. They don't feel like they're being shunted in any way. You know, they're 100% in. And there's other people that you can feel the difference that it's making mm-hmm. on your personality, on other, on the connecting with other people, on the way that you address other people, that you have conversations with other people, the moods that people are in.
Mm-hmm. People stop saying hi. People stop, like, so
our humanity
is slowly slipping away. The more that we're apart from each other, the less that we interact with each other. We're glued to our phones more than ever. Even I myself have to find myself like, okay, put that shit down, mm-hmm. go spend time. You know what I mean? Whoever they is, are really trying to get us to buy into this technology and separate ourselves from our humanity. Yeah. And like, you see that, just like you said, like it started with masking. And now when you walk by someone in the store, you don't even think to say hi. You don't even think to engage with them. And previously you walk by someone in the store, smile at them, say, hey, how are you? Like, even if you don't know them, that's just what you do as human beings. You interact with each other. There's no more interaction. Human beings exist in community and thrive in community. And we are having community stripped from our lives, which is an essential piece of health.
Mm-hmm. Which is an essential piece of your book that you read, Law of One, which is mm-hmm. at the crux of it. That's the message, is everyone is in a symbiotic relationship with each other, the universe, the plants, the animals, humans, everyone. And so we've thought the same thing. The whole point is to, I think there's another aspect of it, and we'll move off of masks because we could talk about these mm-hmm. till we're blue in the face. But the other element that I think that masks are is I think that they're personally running a beta test on us right now to kind of see who's going to be subservient and who is not, who's going to fall in line and who doesn't, so that they can start kind of classifying us on different levels of threat, for example, or mm-hmm. different levels of subservience, for example. I also think it's training people to everything you just said, the socialization aspect of it. But more than anything else, it's teaching people to kind of, you know how you train a horse? You put, yep. you know, a cart horse. How do you train a cart horse? You put a muzzle on it and you put goggles on it or blinders on it so it can only go one specific direction. And you and over time, it starts to kind of learn that as soon as it's sidled up and the bridle's on and then the saddle's put on and it's put into the reins, that it's just going to go wherever it's led. And so I'm seeing that happening already now. And so it's unfortunate, but I think that I'd like to think there's hope that people are actually starting to wake up. One of the things that you started to go into, and I didn't hear you finish, was on the masks, is why is nobody talking about that cascades of the mask wearing outside of just the psychological element? You know, their suicides are at an all-time high across the board in multiple age and genders. Depression is at an all-time high and rising across multiple levels of people. Alcohol sales, for example, are at an all-time high. Why, if this thing was all about health, this is something I've asked from the beginning, if this is all about your health and safety, why are two of the leading factors of death in this country, alcohol and tobacco, not pulled from the shelves and banned? That's the thing. It's like nobody's asking these questions. And then it's people like you who are asking them, but you get blocked and you get kicked off of social media.
This is one of my favorite questions to answer.